Oh. Is that you, Ongits? You're beautiful, Ongits. I love you, Ongits. Where are you going? Are you Ongits or not? Oh, he's out. Hold on, Ongits. Oh! Oh, hello. Okay! Okay. Hi. Do I put it... Oh. Oh, awesome. That stuff good? Now what? I'm releasing his harness. He needs his vest changed. The eagle cannot speak but may still be of use to you. Change him. Replace Ongit's vest. Where's the other vest? What? Oh, good God. He's got a hole. We have another one like this inside. You got a flower in there. Okay. I don't want to get it mixed up, so... I'm gonna put that there. And I don't wanna do that. No. No, 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 no. I'll be right there, Ongits. I'll be right there. I think we want this. I think. Nice. Hello? What now? Should I follow you? Am I following you? Find an application for the number. There's a 4-digit vest. On the inside of the nest is the key to valuable information. Inside the vest. Oh, 2053. Okay, so I'll keep this one. 2053. Could this be the password for the laptop or iPad thing, whatever this is? iPad thing? 2053? Oh, I can read entries now. Yes. 2053. Keep entering. Awesome. Access granted. Okay. I've got a journal now. Thanks, Tabaha. Tabaha? I don't know how to say. My name is Anebish. I've always lived here because I can't go anywhere else. Grandpa Bachin says lots of people used to live around here, but they all died when the dome blew up. The area has been deserted ever since, aside from myself, Bachin, and Ongits. Ongits has very powerful claws. He obeyed my father and helped him hunt hares. I don't remember my parents. They died in the explosion as well. When the wind picks up, it gets pretty chilly. You can find refuge from it, but not for long. You can't last long without light. That's why I crafted this transparent layered vest, like in that program about greenhouses. It keeps Ongits warm during the day, and when the night's chill arrives, I put him into another warm vest. I collect and digitize flowers. I look for the prettiest ones and make photocopies of them. Tabaha then takes them into town and sells them. The earnings keep him afloat, while Grandpa and I buy cheese. Wait. I can't last long without light. And you can find refuge from the wind. We've got a new genometer. It measures everything. Flowers, insects, people. It clocked Bachin at 47. And the tree by the gate at 24. Even the stool got measured, even though that took a little longer. But when aimed at Ongits or myself, it still shows the same old error. Grandpa says it's all providence. Maybe he's right. I have this dream sometimes. I'm in a strange city. The day is waning. Folks are walking in the distance. There's somebody behind me, but I don't see who. The dream is fleeting, always leaving me with a strange sensation, like I'm supposed to pass something to somebody, but I can never remember what or to whom. I feel some kind of mix of anxiety and chagrin, and it makes me want to go there, to that town. Grandpa Bachin has died. He wanted to do a transfer after losing his sight and mobility. Tabaha even brought him the equipment, but Grandpa died in his sleep. He was buried at the spot he had requested. You've seen that. Tomorrow marks the 4-year anniversary of Grandpa's funeral, which means I'm already 23. Everything is still the same. I tried leaving again, but no dice. I simply lose consciousness like before. I want to find that town from my dream. Perhaps I'll risk it and do a transfer. Grandpa's got no use for his helmet these days, but I might. If I get lucky, I'll wake up in a new body in Ulaanbaatar. Too bad the genometer won't show my number. I know how dangerous it is. When I look up at the poster over my bed, for some reason I remember my toys. When I was a kid, maybe 5 or so, I had a favorite toy, an odd little space case. Angus has found it somewhere and brought it to me. Then I saw dark swirls in the field, got scared, and stashed the toys away for some reason. And to make sure I didn't forget the hiding place, I came up with a clue. Come out of the yurt and fly straight as the crow. On a rock with a snag, look for an arrow. A sorrowful tree will show you the way. A box in the sand will a mystery betray. But now I can't find it. On a rock with a snag, look for an arrow. A sorrowful tree will show you the way. A box in the sand will a mystery betray. Huh. New task. Your child's stash is hidden somewhere nearby. Right. Find your toy. Huh. Straight. Look for a rock with a snag. And there's an arrow on it. This? Like this snag? Is it really nearby? Or just not really? I'm looking for a rock with an arrow. I'm thinking painted or drawn on it. Unless the... But I don't know what consists of a rock with a snag. And... I'm kind of not going... Well, I've never been here. Huh, like rings. Well, somewhere nearby. I don't think this is nearby. Yeah, I'm thinking it's this. Does that mean go this way? How hard is this to find? Now I'm just randomly looking around. Is that something? I think that's it. Cute. No need. Glass balls, cold and heavy. So a music box or something. Sweet treasure, is that what it says? Assorted candies. We're saved. I missed that, whatever that says. Chewing gum insert. A Mongolian comic book hero slays a dragon. Mini calendar for 2058. Sky rings. The construction has begun. I wonder if that's what that place over there is. Sky rings. Your favorite toy as a child was a processing device, the main part of a mechanical body. There are two more parts in the yurt. Use them to repair the young android woman. She may provide valuable information. Connect the processor to the young woman. Okay. Cool. I know exactly where that is, because I've been paying attention to that. So, I don't know. I didn't find it by really following everything to the letter, but excuse me. I just kind of wandered around a little bit. Love the music in this game. Okay, so we need to connect this to the young woman. I guess we have to take the chest off first. But I'm gonna try to... Let's see. I didn't do that. Processor. I did not remove the panel from her head. Okay, that narrows it down. Ugh. There's no room here. I need to free a slot. Alright. Okay. My guess is we don't need that one then. Push the power button, I'm guessing. Find and connect the synchronizer. Something's wrong, I better turn her off. Okay. Some components might be missing. Synchronizer. But we don't need this thing, so... Okay, I can stop with the scary music now. Go in there, because we don't need that one. That one's not working for some reason. A synchronizer. Could it be this? No, it's not this thing, right? I don't know what a synchronizer is. Does it go in here? A strange device on the yellow table. I'm not sure what it is, but its parts are identical to the pictures. Doesn't work. This? I just laid on her. Okay. I'm guessing it's not that. Maybe it's this thing. I don't suppose it's that. Thank you very much. Wait. Can't use it. Okay. You know what? It resets anyway. Yeah, let's put it in there. What's a synchronizer? And where do I get it? Unless... What's that? Well, what's that? Yeah, that's not it. Does anything else come out? So we know it looks like something that... No, I don't want to do that. I'm guessing the synchronizer goes in there. But where is the synchronizer? Where is the continuum transfunctioner? Not this thing, right? Ah! Yes! Let me guess. Wait. Find and connect the container? Is that the container? Is that what I did? Some components might be missing. This thing? This is kind of a container, isn't it? Can't use it. Maybe it's... Ah! Turn it on, right? Switch on the mechanical woman and talk to her. Okay. This will be exciting. Or not. Something tells me you don't have all the energy you need. Hi.
Hi.
Hey.
Hey.
So I'm a guy. Can you hear me?
Can you hear me?
Where am I?
Somewhere in Mongolia, in some yurt.
What happened to me?
I don't know. I don't remember anything either.
Was it you who switched me on?
Yes.
Are you a mulger?
A mulger? Yeah, we don't know what a mulger is.
I don't know, but I doubt it.
Where did you get my neurochip?
Well, you have many questions.
I found it in a cache underground.
What cache?
A long time ago, I hid a cache of toys in the ground.
You were playing with my neurochip and then buried it in the ground?
Nah.
Looks that way, but I don't remember any of it.
And you are?
My name is Enibish, I think.
I think.
And you are?
Not sure who I am.
What do you want?
You did not answer my question.
I want to know what's going on here.
You're not a Mulgar.
Yeah. Oh, okay. Yeah, I don't know what a Mulgar is. Can you explain?
I don't know what a Mulgar is. Can you explain?
Someone who kidnaps people and sells their substance.
Their substance?
What substance? I don't understand.
My name is Ida. And I understand even less than you do. Do not recognize this body. There's something wrong with it. I can't see anything and I don't feel my legs. What's wrong with my legs?
Yes, they are kind of fused together.
They're, fused together. Kind of like a vase.
What?
Does she have a flower vase where her legs used to be? And it looks like it's part of her legs.
You've got a flower vase where your legs should be.
That's ridiculous. I'm scared.
Calm down, Ida. Tell me, are you a robot?
I'm a human being in an artificial body.
You mean you've had your body replaced?
Half of humanity had their bodies replaced. Where did you get my neurochip?
Ida, I've just now found it in an old cache.
The cache you made when you were a child?
Yes, if my journal is to be trusted.
How could my neurochip have ended up in the hands of a child?
From Ongots?
Ongots brought it.
Yeah.
My father's trained golden eagle. I don't know where he had found it.
How long ago was that?
Long. 18 years ago.
Listen, Inhibish. I feel ill at ease here, and scared. I want to remember who I am and return home. Please help me.
I want the same thing. How can I help?
You need to call the evacuators. They'll come and take me away. I've been trying to send a request, but it's useless. My marker isn't answering.
What marker?
What marker?
The authenticity marker. It's like my passport. It's got all my personal data. All requests must be accompanied by data from the marker, but it appears to be broken.
So what do we do?
So what do we do?
I don't know. We might be able to use my neurocopy number, but I don't remember it. I remember almost nothing about myself.
Could it be 74?
Just like me.
Well, at least you're in your home. You know about your childhood, your family.
I bet I'm a robot, too. Or a consciousness in an artificial body.
I'm not sure if I'm home. I don't know this place.
Strange. Listen, why don't you start asking me questions? Anything you wish to know. Maybe that will help sort my memories. Maybe I'll even remember the number.
Oops.
Are you all right?
I feel something is wrong with this body. I can't figure out what, but we need to hurry.
Oh, she doesn't have enough power or something.
Tell me about artificial bodies.
About bodies? All right. They are called M-bodies.
Am I reading about that?
Hold on. Why replace people's bodies?
Because of the epidemic. There was a virus that spread across the globe. A sterility virus. They couldn't fight it, so they developed this body replacement program. Transferring consciousness from a regular body into a mechanical one.
Kind of like a personal refuge?
Right. A temporary refuge. People use it to hide from decrepitude. Once the virus is cured, we'll be able to return to our regular bodies.
Where are your bodies? The virus could be gone by now. It's been years.
The virus could be gone by now. It's been years.
I don't know. It was just so... No treatment worked. Not antibiotics, nothing. There was only one substance capable of destroying the virus, Passium. But the accumulation process was extremely slow.
How was it accumulated?
It was extracted from people themselves. Human beings produced it with their nervous system.
From their emotions, I think.
Nervous system? I don't get it.
Well, Passium can only be extracted from emotions.
Right.
Whenever you experience an emotion, any emotion, your M-body manufactures a little bit of the substance.
A substance produced by emotions?
Yes. Emotions were the only thing capable of making a remedy against the virus. As a result, Passium skyrocketed in value, far surpassing everything else. And every person, they became...
Everybody became a source of value?
Yes, although... there were people whose substance was considered more valuable than that of others.
Who were those people?
People that were special, somehow. They had something. They were greatly respected, but... I can't remember. I think I figured out what's wrong with me. I can't breathe.
Breathe? You need oxygen?
I simply need to inhale air. It's been inherited from my former body, a reflex. I can't get rid of it. All M-bodies have a special module built in for this very purpose. It imitates breathing.
Can I help you somehow?
I need a breathing module. Could you find it for me?
Where do I look? We're in the middle of the step.
Yeah, right.
The step and nothing else? Describe for me what's around here.
The river... some abandoned complex.
What kind of complex?
We've been there.
A big dome with multicolored sails.
Hold on. Yes, I see it. I've got access to it. The Gerbera Garden.
Right.
Enibish, I remember this name. I used to have a connection to this place. I think that it's an amusement park.
Or used to be.
It looks the part.
M-body parts were stored there. In the pavilions. It should definitely have a breathing module.
Body parts in a children's park?
Body parts in a children's park?
They were once used in a show. But I don't remember exactly how.
All right. I'll try.
Find the seventh pavilion. I'll try to find the password to the file database. It may contain my data. If I remember anything, I'll contact you.
Help me understand something. Find the seventh pavilion.
Help me understand something.
What's that?
What's a neurochip?
What's a neurochip?
A consciousness carrier. When a body gets replaced, the subject's nervous system is copied to the neurochip. There it lives and develops, just like in the former body, or close enough to it. For one thing, there used to be no need to reboot yourself.
Consciousness carrier. Reboot?
Reboot?
Sometimes the neurochip needs rebooting to clear the errors that accumulate. I don't really know much about it. Essentially, if too many errors pile up, it starts to disrupt your thinking. You start feeling out of it. That's when the neurochip should be switched off and back on. We call that a reboot, and it is a highly, highly unpleasant procedure.
What do you mean by disrupted thinking?
Well, your speech gets distorted, for instance. You start mumbling as if you're delirious, but it doesn't end there. Your motor functions can be affected. It varies.
So, I can't mouse wheel. Let's see. There used to be no need to reboot yourself, but now there is.
Got it.
Wait, I wanna...
Did you bring the module?
No.
Help me understand something.
What's that?
How is it that emotions produce a substance?
Technically, it's not emotions that produce it, but a synchronizer.
Oh, that's what I put in her, a synchronizer.
And what does it synchronize?
Your consciousness with your DNA. It maintains a link between your nervous system and gene pattern. Thus, whenever you experience an emotion, doesn't matter which one, it generates something like a byproduct. That is the substance in question. Hassium.
Why the need for DNA in a mechanical body?
The consciousness cannot survive without the DNA. It perishes.
How does it perish? And why?
As to why, I do not know. Nobody does. Your neurocopy crumbles and you die in a fit of panic.
Panic attacks.
You shake with terror for several minutes, then slip into a coma.
There's information up there about the panic attacks.
Coma?
Death, really. The neurocopy cannot be restored.
Got it.
One more thing.
Did you bring the module?
Help me understand something.
What's that?
Why don't people want to live in M-bodies?
It's the panic attacks. You can't get used to them. Each reboot is accompanied by a panic attack.
What is that, fear?
Fear?
Not fear so much as... You start feeling warm and... almost swampy.
Come again? Swampy?
I don't know how to describe it. You feel something strange, like a droning, but it's not a sound, more like a sensation. Monotonous. Enovish, I don't want to remember it.
That's fine. No need to.
I want to see something. I just want to see what she says.
Not yet.
Nothing. Alright. So now we need to go out. I'm just gonna... yeah. Can I... one more for the road. One more stuck. We have to go there. And get... unable to breathe in air, a person in an M-body feels discomfort. Head to the abandoned amusement park and get Ida, a breathing module. Get across the enclosure. We know how to do that. We've been there. Somebody's gonna find out the 7th pavilion or something like that. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always seek adventure.